covenant has been in existence before the law. So the law that came later cannot negate the covenant, which is a promise. So how do I come into the covenant? I come into the covenant by belief, by faith.
I leave this place with epignosis. The epignosis of Jesus. The epignosis of the new creation reality. Because you are born of the Spirit. You are a new creation. You are going somewhere. You cannot be stopped. No viper can stop you.
Juma Musa is a man set with an apostolic and prophetic mandate to bring healing, the revelation of God's word to the nations of the earth, and to raise a people of power who will manifest the kingdom through the operation of the Holy Spirit.
We're going to be taking a whole series on this theme, covenant and sacrifice. But listen attentively, because it will bless your life. It will bless your life. And it will change a lot of things in your life. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, covenant and sacrifice. Psalms 50 verse 5. It says, gather my sin together unto me, those that have made covenant with me through sacrifice. When you look at this scripture and you look at it carefully, there are quite a number of things in this particular scripture that we're going to be looking at. But I want to begin by saying that God's perfect moral nature demands that the penalty for sin be death. That is why the scripture said, for the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. You see that in Romans chapter 6, verse 23. However, people in the Old Testament could offer an animal to God as substitute for their lives. People in the old covenant, they could offer animal to God as a substitute for their lives. And that symbolized their faith in the merciful, forgiving God. So each time when they offer an animal as a sacrifice to God, as a substitute for their lives, it symbolized their faith in the merciful, forgiving God. The very act of sacrifice here showed that they had once agreed to follow God wholeheartedly. Yes, the act of sacrifice in this particular verse of scripture shows that they have once agreed to follow God wholeheartedly. And their breach of the condition of this covenant will make God to show up as a judge. Their breach of this covenant that they have already entered in with God. If they break the condition of the covenant, God will show up as a judge. And that is why you cannot make a covenant with God, because you cannot keep the part of your covenant. God can only enter into covenant on behalf of us. And we become beneficiary of the covenant that he has made. If you make a covenant with God, it will be difficult for you to keep the condition of your covenant. But God can make a covenant on behalf of us. And then we follow, or we come into the covenant to become beneficiary of what he has made for us. Right, I would like us to look at the word covenant. The word covenant is from the Greek word, or from the Hebrew word, or from the root word, berit. You know, these are ancient words. And we have ancient Greeks, and some of these ancient words, we don't even use them today. It's just like the old English, the ancient English. You don't use it today. But for us to get it in the right context, we have to look at it in the root word. And the word covenant is from the root word berit. Berit means covenant. It's as a binding agreement between two parties, either individuals or nation. And we look at the scripture that says, gather all my saints together. Those that have made covenant with me by sacrifice. It means that these people have already come into covenant with God. But I told you, when you breach the condition of the covenant, God will show up as a judge. And that is why you cannot make covenant with God. God can only come into covenant on behalf of us. And we become the beneficiary of the covenant that God has entered into on behalf of us. Amen. You know, there are some people, they always like to spiritualize things. Say, I have raised a covenant with God. You. If they give you just 20 minutes, you will discover that you break the term of the covenant. And that is why the covenant that God made through Jesus, you didn't do anything. God himself came as a son and died for you to enjoy the covenant. Hello. And we have different types of covenant. We have the Noahic covenant. We have the Mosaic covenant. We have the Abrahamic covenant. And we have the priestly covenant. In this series, we're going to be looking at quite a number of things. We're going to be looking at covenant rituals. And we are going to look at acted oath. Those are things that we are going to be looking at in this series. Please, I want us to follow carefully so that we can get it. When you understand covenant and sacrifice, it is done. He said, gather my sin. Why did I dwell on this particular verse of scripture? Because there are a lot of things inside that scripture. Gather my sin together. Those that have made covenant with me through sacrifice. When you look at verse 6 of that scripture, he said, and that the heaven shall declare his what? Righteousness. For God is judge himself. So each time when you break the term of the covenant, God will show up as a judge. In the Mosaic covenant, the people come into covenant with God. So when they break the covenant, they suffer the consequences of breaking the covenant. But in the Abrahamic covenant, God himself came into the covenant, and Abraham was watching how God came into the covenant, because when God was coming into the covenant, God made Abraham to sleep. And when Abraham fell into sleep, Abraham was in a vision, and God told Abraham what will befall his descendant. And before he came out of that vision, Bible said God came in a smoke. And God strike the covenant by himself. But in the Mosaic covenant, the nation, that is why we say the word covenant is from the root word berit. Berit means covenant as binding agreement between two parties, either individual or a nation. The nation of Israel agreed to come into covenant with God in the Mosaic law or in the Mosaic covenant. And that is why you come into covenant. When you break the covenant, you suffer the consequences of breaking the covenant. Can we go to Exodus chapter 24 and then verse 7? Can we read it together? One, two, go. And he took the book of the covenant and read in the audience of the people. And they said, all that the Lord has said will we do and be obedient. Which means they come into agreement with the term of the covenant. They agree to sign the covenant, which means you come into covenant with God. How can you survive? You cannot fulfill the term of the covenant. We are enjoying the covenant that he has made with us in Christ Jesus. We will come to the sacrifice of the covenant of Christ. We'll come to that. But we have a long way to go before we arrive at that. That's why you need to get it here. And I began with the Mosaic covenant so that you understand that in the law is do and don'ts. If you do this, I will do this. But in the Abrahamic covenant, it's not do and don'ts. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Do you get what I'm saying? That is why we are blessed in Christ through Abraham. We are not blessed in Christ through Moses. Because in the Moses law, if you don't do this, I will punish you. If you do this, I will do this. But in the Abrahamic covenant, it's not like that. The Abrahamic covenant is based on promise. Hello. How did I enter into the promise? I entered the promise by faith. How did I enter into the covenant? The promise is of faith. The promise is the covenant. So how do I enter into the covenant? I enter into the covenant because I believe in the covenant that God has made. Hello. I believe and I enter into the covenant. Abraham believed and he received. But in the Mosaic covenant, you must do. He said, do. Don't do this. Don't do this one. How we get it? Now look at verse 3. He said, and Moses came and told the people all the words of the Lord and all the judgments, and all the people answer with one voice and say, all the word which the Lord has said we will do. All the word of the Lord, he told the people, and they say, all we will do, we will do. And all the judgment, all the judgment. In the Abrahamic covenant, there is nothing like judgment. He believes and he receives. Somebody say, I believe. And I receive. And I receive. Say, I receive. Say, in this service, all that God has for me, I will receive. I will receive it in Jesus' name. God gave Abraham the sign of the covenant. And the sign of the covenant is that you and your seed and those that are in your house, you will circumcise them on their foreskin. Genesis chapter 17, verse 11. I want us to see the sign of the covenant that God made with Abraham. And ye shall circumcise the flesh of your foreskin, and it shall be a token of the covenant between me and you. This is the token of the covenant. Verse 12. And he that is 8 days old shall be circumcised among you, every man child in your generation. He that is born in the house or bought with money of any stranger which is not of thy seed. Today, all the male children, because we are blessed in Christ through Abraham, this is a token of the covenant that God made with Abraham. That is why I say Abraham did not exist in the law. Abraham existed in the covenant. And the covenant has been in existence before the law. So the law that came later cannot negate the covenant, which is a promise. So how do I come into the covenant? I come into the covenant by belief, by faith. How did Abraham receive the covenant? He received the covenant by faith. The Mosaic covenant and the Abrahamic covenant, these are two different covenants. Hello. These are two different covenants. And we must understand it so that when you understand this, you know that you have better promises. So God gave Abraham the sign of the covenant. The sign of the covenant was that you will circumcise the foreskin of your flesh. You will circumcise the foreskin of your flesh. Imagine Abraham was circumcised at an old age. Which means before God made covenant and called Abraham into the covenant, Abraham was not circumcised. And God said, Abraham, for you to know that I have covenant with you, you go and circumcise the foreskin of your flesh. And that is why when you give birth to a male child, on the 8th day, the child will be circumcised. Where you take your child for circumcision, it matters a lot. Because covenant can be struck. It's a sign of a token of covenant. Some people, they circumcise them in shrine. Yes. Imagine if they give birth to you. You know, in the olden days, there are groups. If they reach a particular age, they will carry them to shrine, to forest, to circumcise them. They will not allow the women to see when they were doing that circumcision to them. By the time they finish the circumcision, a covenant is struck. And many destiny are attacked. Many destiny. Many people are going through pain today. Because at the point of circumcision, their destiny has been tampered with. And they took you to forest to circumcise you. After the circumcision, you grew up, you see your life, you struggle with life. Everything about your life is struggling. Because the entering point for a spirit is blood. And at times we don't understand. When God told Abraham, he said, Abraham, see, I want to make the sign of the covenant. He said, I will make the sign with you. And he said, I will make covenant with you. Not you making covenant with God. Because you will not keep it. He said, gather all my sin. Now, when the psalmist was talking about gather all my sin, those that have made covenant with me, he was referring to Israel as a nation. Those people that Moses received the commandment and received the law on behalf of them. He said, this is a time you should gather them. You know, there was a time that God said, gather them, and God show up and judge them. Because they have breached the condition or the term of the covenant. So when you make covenant with God, when you make covenant with God, you cannot keep it. And when God show up, it will be a judge against you. But when God enter into covenant on behalf of you, in the Abrahamic covenant, Abraham did not enter. It is God that entered into the covenant on behalf of him. And that is why the covenant of Abraham is connected to Christ's covenant. In Christ's covenant, you don't participate. You didn't do anything. How do you receive salvation? You believe that Jesus was crucified. He was sacrificed. And you say, I believe in the covenant that God has made. He spilled blood so that the covenant can be established. Every time I say, Lord, we enjoy the covenant that you've made for us. And we step into that covenant by faith. Yes. And that's why you will teach different aspects of the sacrifice. There are sacrifices that we can't do them today. Like killing animals, we can't do that one. But sacrifice of advancing the kingdom, building the kingdom, giving money for the work of God, those are the kind of sacrifice that God expects of us. And when we do that, what happens is that God will make an oath of blessing with us. So in the Abrahamic covenant, we have the ritual covenant, and we have also what? An oath of blessing. So, what was the theme of the covenant? Even the theme of the covenant, the sign of the covenant, or the token of the covenant that God made with Abraham still affects us today. You cannot give birth to a male child without circumcising the foreskin of his flesh. He said, this is a token of the covenant that I have made between you and me and the male child in your generation. So if you give birth to a child today, you must circumcise the foreskin of his flesh. But the point that I was trying to explain here is this. Where you circumcise your child matters a lot. Who circumcised your child also matters a lot, because blood is an entering point for a spirit. Hello. So circumcision is a major event in the life of any child that they give birth to. And that is why most children, that their parents are idol worshippers, hardly they can go beyond some arts
They can go above some fight in the spirits. You see great potential. They cannot go beyond some certain limit, because at circumcision their life were limited.
If what Abraham did is still affecting us today, then we must take the word of God very serious. If the covenant that God made with Abraham, he said the covenant is between you and your seed. So the covenant is between him. By progressive revelation, it's not only Isaac. By progressive revelation, the covenant is between Abraham and Jesus. And that is why the animal that they use for the rituals, Abraham did not decide the type of animal they will use. God told Abraham categorically, he said, choose this of 3 years. Choose this one. Bring the animal for the rituals. Right, we're going to be looking at covenant rituals now. Genesis chapter 15, verse 9. I've explained the sign of the covenant. For any wickedness to stand, there is a covenant ritual that gives it strength. Now look at it. Let's take it from 8. And he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? I shall inherit the what? The promise. Look at it, verse 9. He said, take me a heifer of 3 years old. A heifer, 3 years. Everything, three. Everything, three. Jesus died, three. And he rose the third day. And he said unto him, take me a heifer, 3 years old. And a she-goat of 3 years old. And a ram of 3 years old. And a turtle dove, a young pigeon. The pigeon and the turtle dove. No specification. But the other three. These animals that they require for the rituals was specified, not by Abraham. Look at it. And he said unto him, take me a heifer of 3 years old, a she-goat of 3 years old, and a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. 10. And he took unto him all this and divided them in the mix. He divided them in the mix. And lay each piece one against another. But the bed divided he not. The Bible didn't tell us he killed the beds. But the other three animals, he slayed them in pieces. When you cut animal in pieces, what is flowing here is blood. Blood will just be coming down. He lay down like this and blood was coming down like this. Now, go up, 11. And when the fowl came down upon the carcass, Abraham drove them away. Abraham was just looking at the blood coming down because he had slayed the animal according to the command of the Lord. And when vultures come to be partaker of the meat, he would drive them away. Next verse. And when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon him. A man that God gave him instruction, suddenly he fall into sleep. Which means he did not do anything in the part of this covenant. He slept and he was in vision. And when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abraham. And lo, a horror of great darkness fell upon him. He fell into trance. That is vision. Now look at verse 13. And he said unto Abraham, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them for 400 years. God gave him a vision of what would befall his descendant. While he slayed those animals, he fell into trance. He was into vision. Blood was coming out. God open him to revelation and show him what would befall the fourth generation. Abraham died without seeing it. God allowed them to go through affliction so that they can be able to handle life in the new community that they are going. Some of you are humble because of the circumstances that you find yourself in.
Arise and shine. Yes, be bold.
Global Flame present the Daughters of Honor DOH Conference 2017 with theme Fullness of His Spirit. Ministering in Word, Denjumo Musa Gaksu, Rosemary Abercrombie, USA, Faith Denjumo Musa Gaksu, and Jumai Sheni, South Africa. There'll be songs, ministration, dance, drama, and lots more. Join us from Thursday 4th to Sunday 7th of May 2017. Venue, the Global Flame Auditorium, DA of Zarmaganda Rayfield Road, Jos City. Time, 3 p.m. daily. Come, experience God's presence. Global Flame, raising a people of power who will manifest the kingdom.